This boat has been left tied up in Cape Coral in a neighborhood there for months now. And as you can see, it's sinking. NBC2's Jennifer Vakeless joins us live from Bimini Basin in the Cape. And Jennifer, people were living on this boat, I understand?
Well, Kelly, there are trash bags, an AC unit, even a couch. It's safe to say that this boat is an absolute mess, but what's even messier is the backstory of how it got here. It called the attention of five agencies to this vacant lot off Tudor Drive earlier today to investigate.
The water, boating, the view from our places, it's amazing.
Most of the time, that's how Bobby Jenkins describes living on the Bimini Basin. Today, it's different. Seeing this, the owner of what Jenkins thought was an abandoned boat, hopping on board to salvage what he could. Yellow-colored water with clumps of algae spilling in.
That's been there for 5 weeks.
Its owner tells me he bought it 30 days ago for $1,500, tied up to the seawall on the private property. He said he stops by to work on the boat's engine, but would find the needles and trash bags squatters left behind. Neighbors saw them too, calling police.
Two similar men. They're young. Then there was questions about the activity.
It wasn't until this morning when CCPD's marine unit responded with the DEP and Coast Guard. They noticed its gas cap was missing, spilling fuel into the water.
I'm seeing mangrove snapper and stingrays just a minute ago, and they're underneath the oil sheen.
The Coast Guard and DEP did not deem it a threat for pollution. Now, FWC officers are working with the owner for a plan to tow it away. CCPD launching a trespassing investigation of their own. Now tonight you can tell that there is algae just building up around this boat. Right now this in the city, it's perfectly legal to moor your boat in the Bimini Basin, but the city is working to change that and turn this into a mooring field where people would actually have to pay. I'm live in Cape Coral tonight, Jennifer Vakeless, NBC2.